Joining me now is Michael Moran, a lecturer in political risk at the Corbell School of International Affairs at the University of Denver. Michael, great to have you on the show. Thanks so much for joining me this hour. So the chances of Mr. Trump overturning the election results are becoming increasingly slim. So tactically, what does he do next?
Well, I think his game right now is to keep his base engaged. They'd like to see him go down fighting. I don't really think for the last week he's had a real sense that he could overturn the election. I think the idea now is to make the United States ungovernable without his say-so. And when I say that, it's mostly about his leverage with the Republican Party. As you can see, Republicans are quite afraid to say that this election is over, and that's in part because they fear a primary challenge from someone who Mr. Trump backs. He's got his own legal problems, of course, that he'll have to contend with once this election is officially called, but he wants to maintain the ability to block things in the Senate, to be a player maybe in 2024, and so that's the tactic right now, I think.
Or even potentially just kingmaker from Mar-a-Lago for the next few years. But before we even get there, as he stonewalls in this transition process, as you say, actively stoking up divisions, riling up Americans, many supporters believing the conspiracy is coming out of the White House, I mean, there's a sense that this election will never be over. So how dangerous is that?
Well, it's terrible. I mean, it comes at a terrible time, both domestically for the United States and internationally. Domestically, it is the third stage rocket, maybe fourth stage rocket, of cynicism and distrust of government in the United States, which now runs on both sides, from the left to right. Either extreme has deep misgivings about the central government, the state government, any of the structures of the country. That's really a damaging thing, and Donald Trump stokes that, exploits it. It's his bread and butter. Internationally, it's a gift to those who are either peer competitors or rivals in the world, or downright ugly, tyrannical regimes. He has been a friend to tyrannical regimes, with the possible exception of the Iranians. He has been essentially a gift to the Chinese, who all they need to do, I mean, the Iraq War was the start of all this, if you think about it. The United States has been shooting itself in the foot since 2003, one time after another, the Iraq War and then the global financial crisis, which was an American route. And now this, the idea that there's a model competition in the world for liberal democracy versus versus a state-controlled, centrally commanded economic system. It's a joke for a lot of countries that are in the developing world right now. Why would they want an election like the one we just had in the United States?
Well, I mean, in many ways, as some experts have said, is that essentially this president seems to be lighting fires on his way out that Mr. Biden's going to have to put out. So with that in mind, particularly internationally, you speak about China perhaps using this as an opportunity. Where else do you see the next six or more weeks until January the 20th? Is there being real concern about how this administration leaves the world as they close the door behind them?
Well, you know, there's always the dark scenarios. If the North Koreans were ever going to do anything crazy, this would be the moment. The Russians in Belarus, for instance, or Karabakh. I honestly don't think those are likely scenarios. But the degree to which the United States has lost influence around the margins, the role the U.S. has played since World War II, really, is to kind of balance these status quo situations in various regions around the world, whether it's Southeast Asia, Latin America. The United States has been a kind of balancing, often an inconsistent one, and sometimes overzealously intervening in these places. But its presence in these regions has, generally speaking, brought stability and dissuaded crazy moves by ambitious dictators. So if that's a possibility in places like Ethiopia and Eritrea right now, for instance, or in Syria or in Yemen, and in countless places, Myanmar, where governments have wondered whether they could get away with, and now there's complete dysfunction in Washington, And this is the moment, if you're that dictator, to take advantage of it.
Michael Moran, thank you so much for joining us. Great to get your expertise. Thank you.
Thank you.
So you are watching CNN. Coming up, deadly climate.